Hi everyone, I'm Dr. Ashia. I work as a senior resident dentist in Srinagar colony of Partha Dentals. You can find us opposite to Ratnadi in a lane beside MJ College of Engineering and Technology, above Atlas Footwear on second floor. So today's awareness video is all about how does the cavities or caries form and what are the causes and what are the symptoms which one suffers with the caries and what are the treatment processes. And let me tell you guys, caries or cavities are totally preventable. So let us start with how these cavities or caries form. What are those cavities or caries? So take a look onto this denture. As you can see, caries or cavities are nothing but they are permanent damages which could be caused onto the tooth surfaces and which are not repairable basically. So when there is a permanent damage caused to the enamel, enamel is nothing but the outermost surface of your tooth, it is the hardest surface of your tooth. So when there is a permanent and irreversible damage onto the tooth surface, it is called as caries. So, cavities. Where all can you find cavities? Take a look onto this. So, you can see these cavities into three areas. Basically, the first area is, as you can see, the visible area. Sometimes caries or cavities can happen in the visible areas where we can make out or where it is easy for a person to know that they have caries. But as you can see, sometimes they also happen in hidden areas. So these hidden areas, generally patients cannot make out when they have such hidden caries or cavities. Reason, because they are caused in hidden areas. So basically, when a patient has hidden caries or cavities, a dental visit will always help them to get rid of them. Apart from that, how does this caries or cavities are caused? So a majority of you might be seeing a very soft white surface plaque onto your tooth surface, which generally adheres if you are not properly maintaining or if you are not cleaning your teeth after eating. Or this is nothing, this soft debris is nothing but its accumulation of bacteria in a form of a colony which we call as plaque. Plaque, when it is left untreated or when it is not removed from the tooth surface, it starts aggravating those bacteria, starts releasing certain toxins, certain kind of acids which causes destruction of your enamel. So this destruction of enamel, when becomes deeper and deeper, they not only affect the outer surface, take a look. They not only affect the outer surface, but this slowly starts engraving or this slowly starts going into a deeper surface of tooth. And after some time, they might reach a final layer within the tooth, which is called as pulp. Pulp is nothing but it's an accumulation of blood vessels and nerves which are being provided to the single tooth. So when the pulp is affected, that is the time when patient starts having pain. So now, what are all the symptoms through which a person can suffer? So basically, when caries or cavities are in the first stage, patient does not have a major symptoms. So only thing which he might be suffering through is the food lodgment. Eventually, when there is a hole, there will be a food lodgment causing a discomfort to a patient. Apart from that, he might have mild sensitivity or mild pain on chewing and biting. So this all is seen in a mild caries or first stage caries, where only the first surface or the very enamel surface of your teeth is being affected. Once these bacteria start growing inside and when they go deeper into the layers, it is then when patient starts having sensitivity. If left untreated, the infection might infect the whole blood vessel and the whole the blood part of your tooth, causing it to become as an abscess. So that is a time when patient realizes that they have this continuous pain or they need some treatment. So caries are totally preventable. If you take proper steps or if you come down for regular dental checkups, then each and every caries can be prevented. When it comes to children, caries are number one childcare problem or healthcare problem which you can see in children. In children, these caries are totally preventable. If you are using a fluoride, how can you prevent these all caries? There are certain things which if you follow judiciously, you can prevent caries in children. First thing, using of fluoride toothpaste in children above 2 to 3 years. Fluoride toothpaste, as it consists of fluoride, they form a thin film over tooth surface, saving those tooth from bacteria and their adherence. Apart from that, regular visits to dentist will help you out. And yes, children who has a frequent snacking, sipping habit, they have to be controlled. And you can also see them in babies who actually generally do the bottle feeding. So these all things contribute for caries formation, and they can be prevented. Once a caries is formed, then the treatment line is, if it is just superficial caries, then you can get it filled with certain kind of dental cements, which we fill and then save the tooth from further damage. Or if it is not in a very first stage, or if it's just an involvement or the very initial stage of the caries, then also we can prevent them from becoming bigger or from causing a bigger destruction by using a certain cements which are called as pit thin, which is sealants. So these sealants will not only prevent the further damage, but also save the tooth from the future damage also. So apart from using fluoride toothpaste, apart from frequent rinsing, avoiding snacking of sipping of sugary juices, you can also visit to us so that we can help your child with the dental sealants. Let me tell you people, children will never come and say you that they have so and so problem until and unless it becomes very unbearable for them. So before it becomes unbearable, you just take a look or visit us at Partha Dental, so that even any small caries or any small discrepancy can be seen, arrested then and there itself, and being treated or prevented. Patient who has such kind of caries or children who has such kind of cavities, they definitely have eating problem because they cannot chew properly because of mild sensitivity or pain or food loss problems, pertaining to which their overall health is affected. They are shown to have lesser weight then compared to the normal height or weight which the children of their age group should have, and they will have concentration problems also. And yes, when their smile is affected, then eventually it always makes them to have a lower self-confidence. So let us save our children from all such discrepancies, and you can visit us at parthadental.com for appointment, or you can call us on 91000 15150. Thank you so much.